Then let's solve the exercise. Okay, the first question is: write down a pair of integers whose sum is -7 and b1 is difference is -10 and c1 sum is 0. So now we have to write down a pair of integers whose sum is -7. The first question is a pair of integers whose sum is -7. So we have to add any two integers, then we will get the -7. So which are those integers? Let's say here there is a 7, -7. Okay. So let's try here. So -5 + 2 = 7, right? So if it is a -5 and it is a plus of -2. Okay, so we will get as the sum -7, right? Yes. Now write down the answer. Pair of integers. Pair of integers whose sum is -7. So which is equals to, write down here, -5 is a negative integer. They said sum, so we have to keep addition symbol. Then -2, so which is equals to -5 + -2 = -7. Okay. Then the same way we have to write down the difference. Difference means we have to subtract. If we subtract any two integer, we will get the difference as -10.
Is a positive.
Okay, so if you take the two negative numbers. Take any two negative numbers whose difference is 8. Okay? Yes. Let's try here. You may take any other two integers. Okay? So now I will take here minus 4, minus half, minus 12. Okay? The first one is minus 4, minus half, minus 12. Which is equal to minus 4, right, as it is. So minus half, minus 12, additive inverse is plus 12. Then here there are the unlike signs, so subtract here. 12 minus 4 is 8. 12 is the greater number, so we have to keep it as a plus. Okay, then the B question is given to you. Write a negative integer and a positive integer whose sum is minus 5. So whose sum is minus 5. So you may take here minus 10 plus of 5. So they said that whose sum is 5. So here they said that I know that 10 minus 5 is 5 and 15 minus 10 is 5, 20 minus 15 is 5. So whatever you take, there are more possibilities. But in the answer, we will get. So we need to get. In the sum, we need to get a negative number or negative integer, minus 5. So there are the more possibilities. First one is minus 10 plus 5. Okay, then minus 15 plus 10. Then minus 20 plus 15. So there are the more. So you may take any other three integers. You may take any one of the integers and write the difference between a positive integer and a negative integer is minus 5. Okay? Then let's I have taken here minus 5, minus 10 plus 5. So minus 10 plus 5, which is equals to 10 minus 5 is 5. Here the greater number is minus. So write it. Okay, then let's see the third one. The third question is, write a negative integer and a positive integer whose difference is minus 3. So write a negative integer and a positive integer whose difference is minus 3. So here they said that, so one of the integer is a negative integer and a positive integer whose difference is minus 3. Okay, so they said that your difference is minus 3. So we have to take a positive integer and a negative integer whose difference we have to subtract it. So in the answer, I mean a minus 5. So I will take a greater number as negative integer. Okay. So if I take the negative integer as 5, so minus of, and again I will take as minus 2. Okay. So now you may see here minus 5. Minus of minus is plus, then 2, I will get the difference as minus 3. With the same type, you may take other examples also. Let's see here, minus 7, minus of minus 4. Minus 7, minus of minus 4. So 7 minus 4 is 3, right? So let's see here, minus 7, minus of minus 4 is plus 4, which is equals to minus 3. Why? Because 7 is a greater number and its sign is negative, right? So the difference of a negative integer and a positive integer is minus 3. Okay, so you may write any other pair of integers. Okay, so now I will write as, so you may take any other pair of integers. Okay, so now I will take minus 5 minus of minus 2. So if we subtract minus 5, so minus of minus 2 is plus 2, and the difference is 5 minus 2 is 3, and 5 is a negative number and it has a greater number, it has a sign minus. So the given difference is, sorry, the obtained difference is minus 3. Okay, it's clear? Yes. Then let's go to solve the third question. This is the third question. The third question is, in a quiz, team A scored minus 14, 10, 0, and team B scored 10, 0, and minus 14. So, in three successive rounds, so which team scored more? Yes. So first, what they are given? Let's write here the scores of T K. Okay. Write here the third one solution. Scores of T K. So scores of T K is minus 10. Sorry, minus 40. 10, comma 0. And the total score of TK is, and the total is equals to minus 40 plus 10 plus 0. So you may see here minus 10, minus 40 plus 10 plus 0. So plus 10 plus 0 is 10, means additive identity. 0 is the additive identity. If we add any integer to the 10, to the 0, we will get the integer itself. That is 10. So 10 minus 40. So minus 10 plus 40, having the two unlike signs. So we have to subtract here. So 40 minus 10 is 30. And here the greater number is 40, it has a sign negative. So the total scores of TA is minus 30. Then let's write the scores of TE. Write down the scores of team B, that is 10, 0, minus 40. Then let's write the total scores of team B. Total scores of team B, 10 plus 0 minus 40. Then add here 10 plus 0 is 10. So 10 minus 40. So both the having the negative in both the integers having the unlike signs, so the difference we have to subtract here. 40 minus 10 is 30. Here the 40 is a greater number, it has a sign negative. So the total score is minus 30. So you may observe here the team A score minus 30 scores and team B total score is also minus 30. So then what they asked here? Which team scores more? So we can say that both the team scores equal score. Okay, so and also we can say that, can we say that we can add integers in any order? Yes, we can say that. So in any order we can add the integers, we will get the same sum. Okay, so then we can write down here, therefore, so both the team score equal marks, both the team score equal, and we can add integers in any order. Okay. Then let's go to the fourth question. So here, fill in the blanks to make the following statements true. Okay, so you may see here they are given the five questions. So in the first one, you observe here minus 5 plus of minus 8, which is equals to minus 8 plus dash. So in the previous class, we have learned the properties of integers. So you may realize that what is the commutative property says that. So what is the general form of this commutative property? It says that A plus B is equals to B plus A. So once you observe here, it is in the form of a commutative property. So 5 is in the first order, minus 8 is in the second order. So again here minus 8 comes in the first order, means the order of the integers are changed. So hence it is a commutative property. So then what we have to fill in a given blank? Yes, that is the first order integer. So here minus 5, we have to fill in the blank minus 5. Okay. So in a blank I will fill minus 5. So hence which property it is? It is the property of commutative. Or you may write commutative property. Okay, then the second one is minus 53 plus dash, which is equals to minus 53. So what is it? See here. So 8 plus 0 is equals to 8. So in the previous class we have learned that additive identity. 0 is the additive identity. If we add any integer to the 0, we will get the sum as integer. So it is also same that. So we have to add here 0. So if we add 0 to the minus 53, we will get the sum as minus 53. Okay, so which property it is? It is the additive identity. Multiplication of integer.